I'm incognito because I have been really, really sick. I have not left the house. I didn't want to put any makeup on really. My eyes are all red and irritated. I have a horrible sinus cold and I have a bunch of other crap going on. So hence the sunglasses and everything. But today I just wanted to show you guys my Curio cabinet. This cabinet I got from Design Toscano. They're a catalog that I've gotten in the mail and I've bought quite a few things from them. They have really, really nice items like furniture, just household decor, figurines, statues, little knickknacks, things like that. It's mostly like Renaissance style, medieval, gothic, things like that. So I'll link the catalog below because you can order stuff online so you guys can check it out for yourself. So I bought this cabinet because there was a few things that I wanted to put on it for a display in my living room because I really enjoy looking at them and I thought other people might also. So first of all, I'm going to start off with the top shelf. This is like my Viking drinking horn. I bought this online from a place that specially makes them and you can actually drink out of it. It's not like a cheap one, it was a really nice one. And I actually bought it for a Halloween costume because I dressed up like a Viking one year, but then I've always really wanted one. And I just think it's beautiful. It has like a, I tucked the strap inside, but it has a strap and everything. The only downside to it is, you know, you can drink out of it, but you can't put your drink down because then all the contents will pour out. But I mean, it's a good weight. I don't know, the strap, you can like wear it over your shoulder. So I just thought it was really nice and I wanted to keep it on display so that, you know, you could, you know, other people could check it out if they wanted to. This next item I bought, I believe it was up in Vermont, in the United States. I don't remember what town in Vermont it was, but this woman made all her own, like, china, I guess you want to call it, or plates and different, I think she had a couple, like, you know, you could, like, something to put drinks in and things like that, but each one was different, like the design of the women's faces. This one was my favorite. I just thought their faces looked the loveliest on this, and it's all handmade. I just thought it was so beautiful, and like the color of the blue, the aqua, and like how it's darker in the middle and it fades out towards the end. I don't remember what the name of the person was that made it. I mean, there's an engraving in the back, but I can't read it. I'm really upset that I don't remember what it was because I would have loved to have maybe purchased some more of her items because they were so lovely and I just would like a whole collection. I didn't really know what to do with the bowl. At first I was going to use it as a soap dish, but then I thought it might get ruined and then you wouldn't, if you put soap in it, then you wouldn't see the beautiful design. So I just kind of set it on my Curio shelf for people to admire. The next two items that I got were in Venice, Italy when I vacationed there quite a few years ago. I want to say it was over 10 years ago. These two items, they're little leather masks that were handmade. I just saw them, I just thought they were like so sinister looking that I had to have them. But it just amazes me what people can do with different materials. Especially with like the leather, I just thought they did an amazing job. And then there's the smaller one of the two. When I traveled to Venice, that was like my favorite city in Italy that we went to, because we went to a bunch of different places and I just thought it was so like magical and beautiful there. Like I would totally live there. I just loved it. There were so many things that I wanted to buy there, but you know, stuff gets expensive, so I couldn't spend too much, but I did get a couple things. So these were two of them. And then the other was this mask. They had tons and tons of different masks there, because you know that's the thing in Venice, like they had all the different ornate masks. I just thought this one was beautiful. It had those, like the musical notes on part of it, like the gold and the cream color. I wish I had like a ball to go to where I could wear it, but I don't think people really have balls anymore nowadays. This item I actually got from the same catalog, Design Toscano. I want to say it's like a weeping angel. It's quite heavy. You can see it's like the angel is kind of crouched over with her head hung down. I don't remember how much this was. I remember it wasn't that much money, maybe like $30. So I thought that was a pretty good price for something so unique and really lovely looking. The next few items are Hobbit and Lord of the Rings themed. I love the Lord of the Rings and I love the Hobbit, so I wanted to collect some items. I don't know if you know the story of the Hobbit, but Thorin, who's a dwarf, his homeland is taken over by Smaug the dragon because it contains all the gold inside the mountain, and years and years and years later he goes back with the other dwarves to reclaim their homeland, and they need this special key to get inside the secret door. I think they also have a version that's a necklace. That would be awesome. I want to get that also. I think this is a little big to wear for a necklace. And then this is a wall plaque of the map that they have to tell them how to get to the secret door, how they can uncover it and get all their gold back. Has the dragon here, shows the Misty Mountains. This is, I think this is written in Elvish. I think they're called moon runes. Like they can only be seen by the light of the moon. This item is actually not mine. It is John's. He was in somebody's wedding who had a Lord of the Rings themed wedding. And it's like a alcohol decanter. And it has a quote on it. It says, "It is no bad thing to celebrate a simple life, Bilbo Baggins." I thought that was really unique. I'm sorry, I'm a geek. I love The Lord of the Rings and I love The Hobbit. I don't know if anybody else out there does. And the next few things are geeky also because they're Harry Potter. They're a bunch of Harry Potter wands that me and John have collected. So the first one that I got was, this is Fleur Delacour's wand. I just really liked the design on the end. Thought it was really unique looking. And this is just a regular wand because they also have interactive ones that you can use in Harry Potter World at Universal that has like a little sensor on the tip and you can cast spells throughout the place. But this one was just a regular one before they had that feature. This is John's. This is Harry Potter's wand. It's just a basic handled one. This one's mine. This one's an interactive wand. I don't know if you can see the tip. It has the little thing on the end. This is Narcissa Malfoy's wand. I love the silver and the black. And then this is John's interactive wand, but I think this is Sirius Black's wand. I think that's who he got. And it has like all different little carvings on it. Sorry if the camera's not focusing. And last but not least, the most special wand of them all is this one, because in Harry Potter World, they have this special little thing where you go in this room and they have, it's supposed to be Ollivander's wand shop, and it's like a small group of people go in, and it's supposed to be Ollivander or just like another wand maker comes out and he chooses somebody to demonstrate a wand working. And I have done it a few times. I never got picked, and then finally I got picked. I was so excited. I couldn't believe when he picked me. And basically just say, you know, okay, well, try this wand out and do this, and oh no, that wand's not suited for you, and like lights go off and like things happen. And then finally they pick the wand for you, and this is the one I got. How suiting. It's a, a skull on the end of it. So I purchased that one. Obviously it's a gimmick to get you to buy a wand, but I was like, I feel so special, so I got it. And then last but not least is this knife. This is Rambo's survival knife. It's actually a real knife, it's sharp. And it has like this jaggedy serrated edge and this sharp edge. But in the handle, it unscrews. And I don't know if I can get it out. Inside here is like a little kit with different survival items. So it shows you on the back of the box what is in that little survival kit. It's matches, looks like a needle, thread, fishing hooks, some sort of like little, look like little weights. I don't know what they are. And then it looks like another type of like a little blade. I hope you guys can see it. So I thought that was pretty cool. And it comes with a case. This case, and you can wear it like on your belt. But obviously it's just for display. I don't think I'm gonna need it for survival in the woods anytime soon. It's in a box right now. I'd like to get a glass case to put it in so you can actually see it and not just see the box, but I haven't gotten around to doing that. So that's it for my collection. There are just a few items that I really cherish and I wanted to put out for other people to enjoy when they come to the house, or just for me in general to look at and just as a reminder say, oh, I have some cool things. But I hope you guys enjoy this. Let me know what you think of the items, if you guys collect Harry Potter wands or any type of Hobbit or Lord of the Rings items. And I really appreciate you guys watching. Stay dark, my friends, and until next time.